This is Hirsty's Dosecast.
Galaxy.
Hello and welcome to Hirsty's Dosecast number 31. And we start this particular Dosecast, our 31st, with some very sad news. We've gone over the hill and we're now on the downhill slope to Christmas 2007. There's just 109 days left to get all your Christmas shopping in.
I thought you'd started already.
Yeah, but I don't like to talk about it.
Hirsty, I'm not talking about your period, darling.
Oh, no,
I'm talking about Christmas shopping.
I've had that. Oh, yeah.
To be fair, there's... To be fair, there's 109 days, which is 108 days more than most people. Well, I need anyway.
Yeah, but you do all yours on the last day, don't you?
Well, absolutely. The sale's on by then.
Hopefully this Dosecast got to you safe and on time. As you know, we've been having a few IT problems.
SHIT problems.
At Galaxy Towers. It took Scott until 9 o'clock last Thursday night to get it online, bless him. Working his little Geordie arse if he was.
He was. I know it's 2 hours past his bedtime. He's only 14.
Right, coming up on the Dosecast. Listeners think it's funny to push me down the slippery feminine slope again.
I've waxed me bits.
After 3 weeks of dating my mate, gullible Becky was finally hooked up with a fella.
Oh, yeah, I said that. Yeah, he's lovely. Oh, yeah, I thought we were going for looks first. Right.
Sorry, I'm just caught out by that bit.
This is Hirsty's Dosecast.
Galaxy.
Hi. I have been known... I have a couple of feminine tendencies. I like to call it a modern metrosexual man, to be quite honest.
Whereas I like to call it a big Nancy boy.
Oh, big girl's blouse.
How are Geordie producers?
Yeah.
You being a bloody woman again, aren't you?
That was good, Dad. That's what they say.
Scott, you being a bloody woman again, aren't you?
You f***ing grow a pear, pet.
Yeah, grow a pear.
Hirsty, grow some bollocks. So I started talking the other day about this dilemma that I've got.
A nice manly topic.
I've got this dilemma between a Apple Mac computer or a Microsoft PC. Now, I want a new laptop, and I've got lots of friends who say, get a Mac, they're cool, they never crash, they don't get viruses, they're brilliant. So I'm thinking, all right, okay.
And then you look at the price tag and think, ooh.
Yeah, well, but it could be a good investment, a long-term investment, not just the here and now.
Well, listen, here's a picture of me and my mate Gav. Gav, by the way, is the face behind the continuity on Five.
There's the voice behind it, not so much the face.
Well, I suppose, yeah. Yeah, the voice behind, yeah, that probably makes more sense.
But now you're seeing his face, look, it's not a bad face.
Yeah, he's one of them anyway. He's one of the fellas who introduced its programme on Five. I can't call it Channel Five anymore because he's told me off for saying that.
It's called Five.
It's called Five.
It's called Channel Five. They can try and change it all they want.
Gav's the one on the left, and he's there holding the price tag. As you can see, 1,900 quid.
Wow.
Woo! That's for a MacBook Pro. Anyway, I was talking about this on the air the other day because I thought to myself, you know, I'm in a bit of a dilemma, and I thought, I'm going to have to share it with the audience.
Of course we share all our life with the audience.
It weren't going down too well, to be honest, after about 5 minutes of... Yeah, you heard me right. 5 minutes of talking about it. This topic is boring. You're not making me laugh today. Sarah in Leeds. Twinned with a text from my friend Rachel. Simon, I've been at work for 24 hours. I'm now on my way home, knackered. Please talk about funny stuff to keep me awake, not computers. Was relying on you guys.
See, it is a point I did make earlier that you could only really touch on this topic.
This is what I tried to do.
There's a lot of girls out there who will be just like, well...
My God, I'm having a facial in 2 weeks' time! I'm booked in again! I've got ingrown hairs. I've waxed me bits.
You see, have you seen what you've done, Sarah and Leeds and Rachel?
Tipped him over the edge.
Have you seen? He was coming over to the manly side. We were getting talking about computers. It was going to be cars next. I was going to get him into football.
Moisturiser!
But now look what you've done. You've set him back. Now his estrogen levels have gone back up through the roof.
What's it like to wear mascara?
Hey, have you seen? I hope you're pleased with yourself, you two. Very, very good. Thank you for that. I was on a 6 week program of beefing him up, and now it's all gone back, and it's now Eastern FM. I hope you're very pleased with yourself.
This is Hirsty's Dosecast.
Galaxy.
Becky, the head of
hot liquid distribution for Hirsty's Daily Dose. And she's damn good at it.
Even though she hasn't got an MVQ in it, although you can get an MVQ, you have to do 20 hours to pass a course in making coffee.
In Cornwall.
Yeah. She also acts as first defence against the psychopaths ringing in to complain and does a fine job at decoding the many text messages sent in. She decodes them into proper English.
Yeah.
I'm trying to do a Simon Bates impression because this is our tune music, and for those people listening who are old enough to remember that, you get what I mean. For those...
Don't you just seem like you're doing a silly voice?
Exactly.
I thought it sounded more Mark and Lard to me. Sorry.
Probably did actually.
The one where I can't remember the character's called.
Fiery White.
That's it. That's what it sounded like. Sorry.
It did a bit Fiery White, didn't it? Anyway, so she is pretty fit, but she is actually. She won't mind me saying this. Possibly the most picky person in the world.
Well, she is when it comes to blokes, definitely.
Which means she hasn't had any for a while. I bet she's had a rabbit out a bit, but she's not had any for a while.
She was saying the other day, it's practically healing up.
Yeah. Anyway, JoJo can't quite believe this, so she set out a few weeks ago to get Becky a date. Now, the entries came in, JoJo went through them, picked a winner. The person was Adam of Barnsley. Now, Wednesday night, the date was confirmed and Becky was taken on a date to my old stomping ground, Barnsley Bowl, with all five of us that work on the show as chaperones to make sure she didn't put out on first night and be a right old slapper. This is how it went.
Okay, so we're in the back of a pink stretch limo. Woo-hoo. And it's Becky's day. Becky, looking lovely. Nervous. You're not happy with your outfit, are you?
I'm not happy with my outfit. I had a stress. I had a fight with about, half my wardrobe.
I think all girls and guys get stressed about their outfits on the first day.
And that left me no time to do hair and makeup. And no, I'm not.
Your hair looks fine.
Well, I didn't have time to put my extensions in, otherwise I wouldn't.
Oh, you're going to put just extensions in, were you?
Oh, well, you know.
No, you're better to go natural, so you can see what he's getting. There's nothing worse, right, than going on a date and your hair's falling out, your chicken fillets, and it's all not real, you know what I mean?
Don't go changing, trying to please me.
Nice smile, nice eyes.
You never let me down before.
Yeah, she's a very nice lass, she's very pretty.
I don't imagine you're too familiar. I love you just the way you are.
Oh, I really like him. He's a really nice guy and he's really friendly and gentlemanly and he's really fun.
Alright, and if he asked you for your number, what would you say to him?
Oh, I don't know, he's not asked.
Right, mate, it's a night's gone on. What's your impression as it's carried on?
Well, it's a bit limited at the minute because I've not seen her for a long period. JoJo just seemed to come out of blue and attack her.
Stop it now.
And that's where the date ended.
You spoiled it.
Stopped. The day ended then. Becky was rushed off to hospital.
Yeah, she spent the rest of the night. 48 stitches in her face.
Rest of the night spent in casualty, yeah. and the day ended, and that really was that. So the end of Get My Mate a Date.
So well, JoJo got Becky the date, so she giveth and she taketh away.
I'm kind of like that.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to maim you. We stopped going on about it. It was an accident. I was just doing my victory dance because I actually knocked down some pins.
No, we're joking. JoJo was doing a little bit of a victory dance and caught gullible Becky in the face with her nail.
With my thumbnail. I've bitten it off now.
Wasn't even manicured.
Well, it wasn't, was it?
No.
It's not even French polish. That's what she said to me. What a diss.
Anyway, so the date did continue. We're only joking, yeah. It was just a great point to stop it, to be quite honest, just to milk it a little bit.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you met Adam, lovely fella. All his mates are good lads.
Uh-huh. Oh, he had nice people, didn't he?
The morning after. No, not like that.
Unless there's something you want to tell us, Becky.
I was going to say, the morning after, what do you think, in retrospect now?
Yeah, he's a nice guy.
She's not giving anything away because obviously at this stage, he hasn't texted her. She hasn't texted him.
Yeah. Have they got each other's numbers?
Yeah.
I saw them exchanging numbers.
I tried to take a picture of them and she collared me.
Yeah, I collared him.
Of that moment.
Yeah, he's a mix of his Hirsty.
So she's not going to sell us anything because she's playing it cool.
I'm being coy.
So you've got each other's numbers?
You may have.
I think...
have to watch
Scott,
this, babe.
Scott, yeah. Do me a favour, go and grab Becky's phone.
Oh, no, what are you doing?
See if he's in his lover, man.
Scott!
Let's just find... Is it there? Is it here? Let's find out if there's a text from him. I'm sure at some point...
Get off his...
Oh, you can't go in her inbox. That's none of your business.
Her face then was an absolute picture.
There's stuff in her phone.
There's stuff in her phone
that you don't want us to see.
I have a thing about going through people's phones,
well, I'll be
and I don't,
mine from
and
you.
I don't, and I don't like it, so I would not do it to you. But I just want to see the effect that happened on your face then.
Yeah, that was going to be a fuming moment.
Yeah. That was going to be your face then,
especially if you went to gallery pictures.
Exactly. Yeah.
Becky's boobs won.
So it all went good then. Wrapping it up.
Yeah, it was good.
Are you going to see him again?
Who knows? You'll have to just watch this space.
Adam, if you're listening, that's a cue for you to give her a text and offer to take her somewhere. Dinner, maybe a drink or something.
Yep.
Just the two of you.
Yeah.
Without us lot.
Exactly, yeah.
Be a lot safer.
The picture's on the website, galaxyfm.co.uk.
Did you hear that dig? It'll be a lot safer. I suggested you go on a second date at Donny Dome. She went, oh no, you'll slice me limbs off.
Hirsty's Dosecast, Galaxy.
We've had an email.
Oh, steady, steady.
Wow.
Do you know what I've said over the past few Dosecasts that I actually will collate all the emails that have come in recently and mention them? IT problems, deleted all emails. Whoops. So I've lost all the emails that came into the Hirsty at galaxyfm.co.uk email account. I've only got the ones that have come in for the past couple of days.
So send it, if you have sent one and we haven't read it out and you've been listening every week for your little mention and your picture on thingy.
Or you could send it to me, JoJo, and I'll collate them. Yeah. JoJo at galaxyfm.co.uk.
Yeah, send it to both of us.
Because I'm going to say, honestly, you are a bit rubbish at things like that.
No, I'm all right.
Unless of course, you're an extremely attractive girl, then send it to Danny at galaxyfm.co.uk. And I'll have a bloody good look at it for you.
Hello to Emily, who's emailed in. Hello, Emily.
Morning.
She says, thanks so much for the mention on Dosecast number 25.
Wrong show, love.
I know, I realised.
Morning. I've played it to all my friends, and I thought I would write again and add a picture of myself.
Ooh.
So here you go. There's a picture of her wearing a nice green t-shirt there or a green top. There's a bed in the background.
Yeah, you know,
hi.
Yeah.
Is that on the bottom shelf there? Is that all your files and folders and stuff?
How old is she?
I don't know. She looks about 17.
Please don't draw a cock on my head.
She says, please don't draw. Here's a cock on her head.
Oh, yes, look at that.
No, you can't draw her a cock
look
on her
that.
Head.
Look at that. No. And now the cock from her head is gone.
Can she have some comedy glasses and a moustache?
The cock from her head has gone, and now it's on her lips.
Hey!
So childish. I would have just given you some glasses and a moustache.
No.
She's lucky she's not got a spunking cock.
Oh, no.
Here's a spunking cock on her head.
Yeah, look, it's dripping all down her hair.
I'm really sorry, Ellen.
Oh, it suits you, that love.
If you would like to be abused on the Dosecast, send your emails today. Don't hesitate.
Preferably a picture as well so we can mock you, especially if you're ugly.
Hirsty at galaxyfm.co.uk.
This is Hirsty's Dosecast.
Galaxy.
Sorry, it had to come out and it just so happened that it came out at that point in time. I can burp on demand, mate. It's a quite spectacular talent that I have. Would you like any words burping or anything? The alphabet I can do?
Yeah,
anything?
Anti-disestablishmentarianism.
Oh, my God, that made me want to throw.
Hey! Sorry. I just enjoy burping, that's all. It's a little pastime of mine. Right, that's it for Dosecast 31. But before we go, we're just going to play something that may actually develop into a kind of mini Dosecast feature. The powers that be on the Dose, well, they think they're in charge. Obviously, it's us three. They think it's moderately entertaining and gives you an insight into what happens when records are playing. Now, the working title, they say, is Eavesdropping on the Dose. And our production team behind this show thought it'd be a good idea to kind of do this. Now, it all came into mind after Scott, our Geordie producer...
He secretly taped me, didn't he?
Yeah. He managed to record JoJo confessing about stealing some bowling shoes.
Honestly, I've got to check my house. I'm going to get swept when I get home because I've got a feeling the secret mic's all hidden around my house.
Now,
the cameras actually, love.
I've not actually heard this, so...
Let's hear the audio they've selected, the powers that be.
The little script I've got, it says, we'd like to start off with a weird conversation you lot had in the studio after Hirsty thanked a ginger-haired person that worked on the show. And he said he was his favourite ginger.
Okay.
Okay. I'll say that. Hang on.
Another one,
isn't he? I've got two gingers now. Forget that Al's gingers. Well, you're both my favourite. Oh, I've just started something here, aren't I? Shaven ginger. Yeah, yours is not that ginger.
It is when it's when it grows out. When it's not short.
Yeah.
Do you want to see me pubes?
They're bright ginger.
Jesus Christ! Bright ginger.
I've never seen a ginger man's pubes before.
I've seen ginger pubes. They've always made me chuckle. I've never seen a ginger man's pubes.
Bruh!
Where was I? Why didn't I see the ginger pubes?
He's in later this afternoon. I'm getting to honestly, they're f***ing radioactive. Yeah.
That's Al Kelly, who used to work on our show.
Oh.
And he's now back doing some admin stuff here at Galaxy.
He has been helping out, hasn't he? Bless him. We love him.
Yeah, that's what we do while records are on. Talk absolute bollocks. So
whilst the records are on, yeah, and whilst we're on the radio.
Well, I suppose so, yeah. If you do want to hear some constructed rubbish conversation, you can get us on FM, DAB in Yorkshire, DAB in Scotland, London and the Midlands, and across the nation on digital TV. There is more online at galaxyfm.co.uk. Right, finish off some Danny Oak's final thoughts.
My final thought today is a bit of a tip for everyone. The tip is, when doing important work, especially on a computer, it's always good to save as you go along, because this f***ing facial having, crap hoarding, Nova driving, hypochondriac Nancy boy has lost the first f***ing edition of this Dosecast. This is the second time we've done it. I'm f***ing out late. I don't want to go home. I'm f***ing knackered. F***ing
didn't save it. It crashed. We had to do it all again. You could have been home an hour ago.
I know!
Danny.
I'm going to do a... Honestly, one of these days I'm going to do an Hungerford, right? I'm going to do a Michael Ryan. I am going to come back...
Where are you going to get a gun from?
I'll get one off eBay. I'm going to come back, right, with a machete or a Kalashnikov, and I'm going to do everyone in this office. You keep f***ing pulling my last nerve, Sunbeam. The end.
For more podcasts... Get online to galaxyfm.co.uk or use iTunes to subscribe. Galaxy.